My name is Allan Blanchard. I'm from Long Island, New York, an undergrad at MIT, and I'm studying material science and engineering. UROP stands for Undergraduate Research Opportunities Program. They're really giving you the resources to like put any idea down on the table and experiment with it. I open up literature and I read, and I'm just like, you know, if I take A, B, and C and I put them together, like, do you think this can work? I was like, I don't know, let's just try it out and see what's happening. And it's something new. And it's something that, when you think about it, it's something of your own, too. So that's really what makes it fun. I wanted to do something in regards to the energy problem. With alternative energy sources, like solar and wind, they're intermittent. When there's lots of sun, if you have a storage device and store that energy, and you give it to you when there's not a lot of sun, then you can make this a feasible energy solution. But the thing now is the storage devices we have, like lithium ion, they're incredibly expensive. So it's almost $1,000 per kilowatt hour in some cases. You need a device that's $100 per kilowatt hour, so that's 10 times cheaper to make this a feasible concept. So the liquid metal battery. The key concept behind this is you're gonna have three layers, all in the liquid state. You're gonna have on the bottom a dense metal. Lay in the middle, that's the molten salt. And then the top layer is the light metal. The beauty behind the entire system really is that you can put them all in at the same cell, heat them up, and then they're gonna assemble by the relative densities of each of these components. What I've been working on is making the battery more robust, more efficient. I'm exploring just new chemistries in general. When you have all the components ready, you take the cell, and this is where you do a lot of your work. It's full with argon, and argon, you know, is an inert gas, so you get really accurate results, and also you make sure that you're safe because nothing really explodes in this environment. However, there are some drawbacks in the sense that when you're working with the gloves here, it takes about 2 to 3 times longer to do any process. We tried to use an entirely new category of electrolytes. We were really lucky to get some really great data. And now we're trying to push it even further to see if we can increase the capacity in a multitude of ways. We developed something that is close to $100 per kilowatt hour now. So it's bringing in the alternative energy sources, and also it's going to allow the grid to be a lot more energy efficient. So it's cutting on both regimes. And when you see that come together, that's like a pretty amazing feat. With this new device, it's going to spark a new economy, because private homes could even store energy at night and then sell it back to the grid the next morning. I think a lot of the consistency that's been in my undergraduate experience has been in research and getting the skills to learn how to solve new and challenging problems.